Hello everybody, it's Lucas here from Swagger Bomb, and I'm back with a brand new quick play video. And this time around, it's a three-parter. It's Micro Machines on the Nintendo Game Boy, played using the Super Game Boy on a Super Nintendo. Hope you're doing absolutely fan-dabby-dozy. Thank you so much for taking the time to check out one of my retro quick play videos. I really appreciate it. If you're new to Swagger Bomb and like what you see, hey, what on earth are you waiting for? Hit that red subscribe button and hit that bell notification icon, because that way you'll be notified every time I upload a retro gaming video, meaning you won't miss a thing. If you are enjoying this video, don't forget to drop me a like on it. It really helps out the channel. Comment on this video. Let me know your Micro Machines memories in the comment section below. I'd love to hear them. This is such a great series. I don't know if there's any fans of this franchise out there, because it's so cool. Don't forget to share this video around with everybody that you know, anybody that you think might be interested in this type of retro content. It really helps with YouTube's algorithm. It allows my channel to grow. It means more blokes and birds across the land will be able to find and access my content consistently and easier. And finally, you can find my social media. There will be links in this video description. So this is actually footage I recorded last night. It was intended for a review, I have to say. I thought I'll just play it for half an hour, just get a bit of footage and then, you know, make a review of it. But I actually managed to get to the end of the game. So I play as Cherry first, and I have a bit of a dry run. I do okay, but I decide, you know what, I can do better. And then I kind of play as Spider, and I just managed to get up to like the 17th race, which is unheard of, because this is like the hardest version for me to get into. Yeah, I got the furthest in comparison to the Master System, which I did many moons ago, that version. It was very, very easy to get into, and I got pretty far, but not as far as I did on this one. So yeah, here we go. We're gonna check it out as Cherry anyway and have a little dry run, and then we'll switch to Spider. So yeah, this is a three-parter pre-recorded gameplay, so it's going to be interesting to watch my progress, because I wasn't really paying attention to what I was doing. I was, but you know what I mean, I had this laser focus, so I was just concentrating on just playing almost as perfectly as I can. Now, you may notice that in some of these races, the power boats control really well. As you can see, it's nice and smooth. But other races, the cars, the handling's just all over the place. But that's purpose built, and you have to work with the handling of that vehicle in order to drive as good as you can. So at first I thought, oh my god, there's something wrong with my Super Nintendo or control, or the cars are just naff, or you know, I keep skidding off the track. No, you've got to kind of learn how to handle that vehicle. And it is crazy, it is bonkers, and you will see occasions when I shouldn't have won, or I shouldn't have qualified. So crazy this game is, so it can turn on a dime just like that. And there we go, we qualified for the chance as Cherry. You get three chances, and the idea is you want to come in the top two. If you're first or second, then you're always going to be alright, I think, up until the last batch of races really. So yeah, and then somebody else gets eliminated, you can choose who you want to play against. So there we go. I'm just going to have a sip of me water, guys, while I'm watching my progress. Very unusual, because I've never hardly ever do it like this, to be honest. Alright, here we go. We've got some 4x4s now, and we're driving on the breakfast table in Breakfast Benz, or Breakfast Benz. Very, very clever title, and I just can't believe they've not compromised anything. Everything looks just as good. They've got everything on here. I honestly thought they'd make cutbacks or something, this being a Game Boy version, but no, everything's kind of here. This is a solid racing title. Just slipped off the table there. Not good. But yeah, everything's here. I thought, oh, they're not going to have the pool table. Surely that's too complex. But no, the pool table's on there. The sandy levels are on there. Everything's been faithfully recreated. I think this was done by Ocean Software, actually, the conversion. I don't know if Codemasters had a hand in this. I think Ocean took the assets and kind of just managed to kind of fit it onto the Game Boy, or do their magic. So I could be wrong. I would definitely need to look that up, I think. But I've noticed they've lent their name to a few Micro Machines games, so whether they brought Codemasters out, or I don't know if that happened, or whether they were just doing them a favour, because I know Codemasters were some of the best games developers ever, I think. But there we go, look at that. We came second. So yeah, hanging in there as Cherry. So where are we now? We've got the sports cars. And this is desktop drop-off. This one is so awkward to do. Yeah, we're literally on a school desk. We have to drive around. I just love how kind of amateur the things are. I'm just going to change the controls here to type A because it's just easier for me. I always like to use B as acceleration, so A is really awkward for me to use. So, oh my god, I just fell off there. So, it's amazing that you get to make these leaps of faith here on Game Boy. So definitely one you kind of want to have on the go, I think. And we're just gonna, oh, watch out for that. Gotta drive around. You need to watch out for the objects as well, because typically on a desk, this is what you're going to see. Alright, we're gonna keep moving now. Oh, these bloody rulers are just in my way. Absolute madness. Right, there we go, we're through. But yeah, getting used to the handling as well. And it's, the fact is, it's like you have to kind of react almost before you know the track's going to turn. So you need to get used to the tracks and then kind of think, okay, well, the bend's coming up. You need to prepare for it a little bit earlier than you would do, I think, on the console versions, which is fine. It's no big deal. You soon get into it anyway. As I said, the layout's the same. It's still tons of fun as well. I have to say, this is just so addictive as well. You know what I mean? Like, the adrenaline rush from this game alone is something I just cannot compare it to for races on the Game Boy. Right, oh, there we go. So we're sticking in there. So I'm just slowing down a little bit here because, again, this was me just getting into it. Oh my god, banging into the edges of things. I'm just going straight ahead. And the fact you have to do it like one more time was annoying me. Come on, move. Oh my god. Right, there we go. Whoa. Rush of velocity. And it's easy to said just to kind of slip off the edge in this one or just get knocked off. Or, but the game, to be fair, does give you ample opportunity to catch up, so it's not totally unfair. And as you learn and get better at the tracks, which you will do, you'll find yourself knocking other cars off. Or, you know, I think some even have power-ups you can use against your enemies, like the tanks where you can blow them up. But that one's pretty fun. I decided to do something really stupid here. Look at that, you cannot skip the track in this one. Most of the time, it'll let you skip a little bit of it, but not fully. So there we are. We're just overtaking the other vehicles there. The vehicles get obviously a lot faster and more challenging as you progress. And there we go. As long as you hit second place, then you're qualified. So for the last batch of races, I believe you've got to be first, but that's fine with me. So here we go. Oil Can Alley in Warriors. I do like these ones, they're much easier than they appear to be. So, just follow the trail essentially. Watch out for glue. Use the oil to your advantage because that will make you a little bit faster. But yeah, the nails and screws and nuts and bolts are just in the way. So you've got to watch out for that because they will impede your progress somewhat. There we go, just avoided the glob of glue there. We're just going to wind around here. As you will see, you will see harder versions of these tracks. They get more and more complex, amazingly more complex. Like, I didn't think they could get any more harder than what they do, but they did. And just goes to show you what a great game this is. Oh my god, see that? We just knocked into, I don't know what happened there, but I knocked into another car and I just blew up. That can happen. But yeah, use the oil, keep moving forward. And eventually you'll get used to it. I will say the worst tracks for me are the sand ones, which surprised me because I thought, oh, the pool tables are going to be the worst ones for me. But I actually like the pool ones because, I don't know, there's something addictive about them and they're fun. And you've got pockets that will teleport you to other sides of the track, which is great. Right, I think I've got to do this one more time. We have, I believe. Right, so twisting round here. Watch out for all the stuff. Keep moving forward. Look at this. He got stuck there. And sometimes, as I said, you can just cheekily overtake them. But I just keep getting caught out by the glue on this one. yeah, if you've not played this on Game Boy, I highly recommend it. It's a great version. I picked it up for cheap off eBay as well, along with a few other Game Boy games. I got Batman, and Batman Return of the Joker, which is really bad. I was quite surprised because it's a sequel to Batman and it's just not that good. But anyway, this was one of the hidden gems I actually found. I thought, I'll give this a go. I like Micro Machines, and yeah, this is all right. There we are. Somehow I got first place. So you see how bonkers this game is. I didn't drive as well, but sometimes you can just get lucky. I think that's what I kind of did though when I got to play Spider, which you will see. I just got totally lucky. So who do you want to play as? Is there anyone else left? There's Annie. We'll let her join. And we got the big wheels now, I think, or the is it the dune buggies? Sandy straights, yeah, so the sand levels are the worst for me, if I'm honest. Mainly because you need to try not to skid. Even though it's very easy to, you've got to kind of control your vehicle as much as possible. There are puddles as well. If your vehicle gets in the water, then it will kind of halt your progress a little bit. So yeah, you need to kind of get used to these types of tracks. These are the worst ones for me, and I think for anyone they can be like a run killer. But you've just got to get used to it. There's like no other way. And look at that, somehow I shouldn't have made it there, but somehow I did. But yeah, there's water, look at that, see, it's easy to skid into the water, so you got to try not to skid, and that's easier said than done, because you're trying to get used to this crazy track. I'm driving like a bit of chimpanzee here, I'm just trying to get used to it. So I think we've overtaken them now, so look at that, nice sort of, nice turn there, as we go straight down into the bend, and as we turn, knock him out of the way. So yeah, it's a real fight. It's a cutesy racer, but it becomes really, really intense very early on. You want to be the best. You don't want anybody else to beat you, but look at that, straight into the puddle there. Right, so keep going forward. Keep knocking into that sandcastle. There we go, didn't fall in the water that time. So keep going forward, take a turn there, there we go. It also records your best time as well, which is pretty good. I don't know if this one's got a time trial on at all. I don't think it has, but as I said, the head-to-head mode essentially is it's the one where you've got to get ahead of the screen. So if you're ahead of the screen of your opponent, then you win. So I don't know if there's a whole tournament involved or whether it's just a novelty they've included, but it's good that it's on here, to be honest. There's slightly different ways of playing this one. Oh my god, skidding around. I got fourth place, so I got eliminated. So yeah, but this is a hard one, I have to say. Takes a little bit to get used to. And we just lost a chance, but that's alright. As I said, I thought I'd include this one as well as my spider run. So here we go. We're going to have a second attempt as Cherry. If I can just get second place, that would be good. Look at this, it's just absolutely murder on the racetrack. So I've done this track before. As you can see, I start getting better at it, so I'm like, okay, I know where that turn's coming up now, or I'm avoiding that. See, look at that, straight in there, it's almost perfect. So you get better as you play. Straight up there, no problems. So if I can just make this corner without falling into the water, that would be good. There we go. Somehow I managed to do it, and that's what you got to do. That's what, like, the point I was trying to illustrate, which you have to drive as perfectly as you can, even though you're not going to. So you've got to have like a really good run and try not to panic, because these cars, I tell you, they will test your patience. The other players, you'll be knocked out of the way so many times, but you just got to kind of hold your nerve and have laser focus. That's the only bit of advice I can kind of give you. Or cheat, maybe, I don't know. Which you can actually do. There's a lot of fun cheats, which I'll show off when I play Spiders. One cheat you can do on the bathtub, where if you go backwards across the finish line, then complete a lap, you'll complete the race. So that's pretty cool. So I should imagine all the cheats on the Master System version. I know there's one for, is it like more lives, or to make it harder, or to improve your handling, possibly. There's things you can do, but it's like quirky things, like you have to drive to a certain object on the racetrack or something. and then you'll hear a beeping, and then I think that activates it. That worked on other versions. I don't know about this one, but I should imagine it's pretty similar because we've got everything else on here. There we go, look at that. Second place. Fantastic, there we go. So Cherry's qualified, that's what we want. Alright, next race, let's do it. Right, what have we got? Oh, we're back in these again. Okay, oatmeal and overdrive. Right, so we're back on the breakfast table. So, yeah, here we go. This one's a really hard one as well. You'll see why. Look at that, you got globs of orange juice or egg. I believe it's probably egg, actually. Right, we need to just, oh, knocked him off there. There's milk there, a bit of milk. I just need to position myself. Again, this track is so bonkers. Things are purposely in your way. You're going to bang into everything on here. So this is the one with the box. Look at that, the Cocos, the cereal box, which you can go on, which they include now, I think, from here on in, on the breakfast table ones. But yeah, this one's madness. You got a bit of a waffle there. And luckily, as I said, all the other races will get caught out too, so you're not the only one. But look at that. Oh. I think with practice, you can kind of swerve around them. Oh, that orange. Right, there we go. Oh no, straight down. Did not want to do that. Right, keep moving. Right, I've got to make this turn. I've got to make it look good. But look at this. If you go too far, it'll let you go so far, I think. But if you take the Mickey, there you go. I've knocked him off. Then you're not going to make it. I hate this because look at that. You can't just drive on it from there. You have to do it from all the way back there. Luckily, that car helped me out. Bit of a coincidence there, but he actually helped me. Nice one, pal. So, I don't know if I'm going to do this, but we will give it a go. Oh my god, I'm stuck in everything. I think I'm almost there. I can beat this guy. There we are, knock him out of the way. Oh my god, I'm not standing for any more of that. So we're just going to drive this way. I believe we've got one more lap to go, so... Sometimes though it does feel like a lot more than it is when you're like concentrating on the race. You're thinking, oh, only one more lap, and it turns out to be two, which I encounter quite a lot. So trying to hold your nerve. I mean, about this game, that's another thing about this game, you need to hold your nerve a lot of the time. I think first place has already been established, but I might be able to get second. Oh, come on. Ridiculous. God, I can't. I just keep slipping off the edge. This is not good. I just forget it. Right off the edge there. Just come third anyway, so I didn't qualify. But yeah, very very difficult. I think I'm gonna have another go anyway. Here we go. Let's see. Yeah, but trust me, my second run gets much better. Much better than this, but I wanted to include this anyway, just so you guys can see my progress. As I said, I can honestly say that my next run is probably just pure luck, because like, I should not have got that far. Like, even when I was playing it, I was doing tracks I'd never done before, and they were much harder, and I was like, how am I doing this? I just seemed to be... Yeah, everyone, yeah, there's moments where you're in the zone and you don't even know how, you're just doing it. That's how it was. I was just thinking, oh, I'll play for half an hour. I end up playing for nearly 2 hours or something. Incredible. So, yeah, what a great run. So, try and improve my lot here. If I don't make it, then, as I says, we will try again as Spider. But, yeah, it's hard for me to remember like what I did because I was just so concentrating on what I was doing. This is just absolutely insane. Alright, I've got to... If I can at least win this race or qualify, that would be good. I can get into the next one. Look at this. All in my way. Keep moving. So you've got to kind of judge it, like, it's hard, but you got to kind of turn before you know it's going to come, and that's when you'll make the best turns. But yeah, I'm just doing terrible here. This breakfast table is just kicking my ass. Can I do this? There we go, right on the box of cocos. That's the hardest thing for me. Right, let's avoid that. Right, oh god. Knock him out of the way. There we go. Whoa, control turn. And I get caught on a waffle, because yeah, of course I do. Right. Really trying it. Alright, I think we've got another lap. Just make this work, that'll be good. Oh, bloody orange. It's great that it's there, but it's good that they recreated it. It's like, I don't think they've missed any objects out here. Oh, is that jam? That might be jam, actually, on the tracks. I remember one having jam on it. This is probably jam, but... Oh, God. Again. Once again, it's like, oh. Have to drive on the box. It's like, oh, can't you just let me off? I'm like, I'm on it. Personally, if I was having breakfast at the table and I saw little cars driving around on their own, oh, fourth place, I'd want to call the exorcist, but that's just me. There we are, so I failed the challenge. Like the loser that I am. Oh, game over, but we're going to try again with Spider anyway, so... But this is where things get really, really good. I start to freaking get in the zone. And actually almost get to the end of the game, so yeah, here we go. Play as my man Spider, the dude with the greatest hair in all of gaming, in my opinion. Right, so it's powerboats. So I'm gonna show you this little cheat. So what you can do, so you start off, right, but then you turn around, you cross that line there, then you just do a normal lap and check out what happens. Like, you're overtaking all the other races. This is like the easiest race ever in the whole history of racing, basically. Look at this. And there you go, it's over just like that. You can't do that with everyone, I don't think. Would be nice, but nice little cheat there. Which, very, very well included. So, we qualified for that one quite quickly. And we can choose other opponents now. So, go for Chen and Cherry. So, my rival now. So here we go, Breakfast Benz, back in the 4x4. So, as you guys know, the first one isn't too difficult. You just gotta be careful not to skid out. Watch out for the oranges, watch out for all the stuff in the way as well. Try and maintain control, that's easier said than done. And don't panic when you hit objects, because it's very easy to kind of get out of control, but it's all purpose built. You know, they've all done this just to frustrate you, but also to teach you to kind of, hey, you know, try and stay calm, try not to turn too much, you'll actually drive much better that way. And look at that, I'm not even keeping to the track and I'm almost ahead of the game here. Oh my god. Right, nice turn there, and there we go, one more should do it. I think there's three laps maybe. I think that's it. I'm sure there's like four on other versions, I don't know, it's been a while. Right, so let's just follow the oatmeal. There we go, first place, come on, alright. But for me it's hard to tell, like, whether how I'm doing, I don't know, I'm not really looking at their positions. And sometimes when I think I come last, I actually come first, so I just don't know. Yeah, I'm so busy concentrating on the race, so there we go. We definitely qualified for that one. I think you can pick up bonus chances as well on bonus tracks. I think you've got to come first like a number of times for that to happen. You get to play like a truck, but you've got like 70 seconds to complete a lap or something of a race. If you don't do it, it's no big deal, but if you do, you get like another chance. But yeah, that's probably the only thing I failed on here most of the time, apart from the 17th race or something. But anyway, as you can see, skidding off the desk there. I was going to say he was doing very well, but yeah, wasn't really in a good position there. So, oh, I hate this. So it teaches you to do things like that, just slow down a little bit if you're out of position, because as I said, sudden movements and you're going to go off the track. So you learn as you go. So there we go, it's one lap completed. Try not to bang into that notepad there. Everything looks really, really well detailed and drawn on here as well. Ocean have done a fantastic job. Right, they have to put two of those on there. The rubber and the ruler and the pencil sharpener. Oh God. But yeah, I hate that. I hate having to do this. I think it's like ridiculous. But it's good to see the other racers kind of struggle with it too. Look at that, I'm just trying to slip through there. But anyway, let's just try and get past this. Oh, it's looking a bit tense now. I've just overtaken the vehicle. Oh, I've just slipped off the edge. Just slipped off the edge, but I might be able to catch up with him. He's a little bit ahead. If I can just turn a little bit, we might be alright. There we are. Look at that. We just eclipsed him a little bit there. Fantastic. So, yeah. Don't be afraid to, like, you know, try and take a cheeky shortcut. As long as it's not too far, the game will actually let you off. And you will learn where you can and where you can't do it. Because you can see... Oh, as you saw, the game shut me down as Cherry when I tried to do it. It was like, no, sorry, I'm not going to let you do that. It's cheating. Oh, come on, yeah. I hate this bit, I really do. It's like, oh, come on, give me a break, man. Give me a break. Just let me get across here. I hate it so much. If you just let me do it, I could do it, man. There we go. Right. Oh. I've just knocked him off the track. I don't know whether that's good or bad. I've just... Oh, first place. So, like, how have I got first? How is that even possible? That's what I'm talking about. I should not have come first. I should be, like, second or something. But, well, rule of game, I guess. I'll take it. All right, next race. I think it's Oil Can Alley. So we're back on using the Warriors. Yeah, this one. Nice simple track, this. Actually easier than the last one. There's minimal points where you can drop off, so as long as you follow the track. If you get caught in the glue, no big deal, just keep moving. And you'll be fine. Oh my god. Ooh, my grapes, there we are. So if we just drive a little bit forward. Nice little oil slick effects there as well. Just avoided the glue. So as you can see, I'm driving much better than I did when I was Cherry. It's got to be Spider's coolness. It's got to be his hair, I think, you know. Right, so move on past there. That guy, I need to get by him. I really need to get by him, whoever it is. It's proving to be very difficult if I can. There we are. Oh, see that? I keep getting caught on objects. That's the thing I hate about this. And you bang into other vehicles as well if they or you are going too fast. It's insane. But hey, if I can just get second place here, that'll do, as far as I'm concerned. I don't mind. Oh my god, what kind of desk is this anyway? Right, move down. Right, I need to catch up with that other vehicle there. Oh, for god's sake, every time I catch up as well, that same thing happens. I'll get caught in glue or I'll get friggin' stopped. By objects. I need to overtake him. There we go, that was good. Keep moving, there he is. There we go, we've overtaken him. Oh, bloody hell, I got caught in the glue though. Alright, come on. There we go. We're ahead now, we're ahead of the game. We might be alright. Might have pulled this back from the brink, I don't know. Avoided the glue. I think we're going to do it. Oh, second place. You know what, I'll take second place. There we go. Whew, that's not easy. That is stressful just watching that. Cherry. She qualified and I came second. But hey, you know, you don't lose a life if you came second. So there we go. Walter's out. And we get to choose someone else while I have a quick sip of me water. Right, here we go, Sandy Straits.